This is a Raspberry Pi 5, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to install Kali Linux, one of my favorite operating systems, on a Raspberry Pi. Big shout out to Steve, one of the Kali developers, specifically for ARM architectures, who sent me a pre-release version of Kali so that I could create this video. Hopefully, by the time you watch this video, it will be available on the Kali website. I'm going to show you all the steps to get Kali up and running on a Raspberry Pi 5 and then attack Wi-Fi networks. One of the caveats is that the Raspberry Pi 5 built-in Wi-Fi adapter does not support monitoring and packet injection, so you need to use an external Wi-Fi adapter, but I'll show you how to do that in this video. Okay, without further ado, let me show you how to get Kali up and running on a Raspberry Pi 5. First thing you need to do is go to the Kali.org website and click download. Select ARM as the architecture. And notice right at the top, we've got Raspberry Pi. At the time of this recording, it's 2, 3, 4, and 400. Hopefully, 5 will be there by the time you watch this video. Otherwise, you just need to wait a bit longer. I'm going to click on the download link to download the software to my computer. As you can see here, I've got the Raspberry Pi 5 software already downloaded, but you would simply click save to download that to your computer. And once it's downloaded, we'll use the Raspberry Pi software to install it on an SD card. So go to raspberrypi.org, click on software, scroll down and click download for Windows. At the time of this recording, the imager software is 1.8.1. That's the software that we need to get to install the operating system on the SD card. So I'm going to open that, click yes to run it. And what you'll notice now is when I click install and run the software, that we have the option to choose a device. So unlike previous versions of the imager software, we now have Raspberry Pi 5 or Raspberry Pi 4 and various other Raspberry Pis listed here. So I'm going to choose Raspberry Pi 5. I'm going to choose the operating system. Now, you could install Raspberry Pi OS, or you could install other general purpose operating systems like Ubuntu, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to scroll down and use a custom image. And the image I'm going to select is this Raspberry Pi software. The previous version will not work. I've tested that. You need to have the latest version of the operating system. So I'm going to click open. I need to choose storage. At the moment, nothing is displayed because you need an SD card. Try and get a decent sized SD card, at least 16 gig. Now, on the documentation, they say that you need a micro SD card with at least 16 gig capacity. This is the documentation for Raspberry Pi 4. I haven't seen the documentation for Raspberry Pi 5 yet, but I'm using a much larger SD card, 64 gig. So SD cards are fairly cheap these days. So look at getting, for instance, a 32 gig or something. So I'll insert that in my computer. And you can see that it's now available and I can select that. So once again, all I did was select my SD card and then I can click next. So as an example, you may want to enable SSH so that you can SSH directly into the Raspberry Pi. You could also specify options such as the Wi-Fi. So those are great options if you, for instance, don't have the Raspberry Pi connected to a monitor and you just want to connect to it remotely. I'm not going to bother with that because I want to show you the initial boot up. So I'm going to say no to custom settings. We're told that all existing data on the SD card will be erased. Are we sure that we want to continue? And the answer is yes. Okay, so now you can see that it's writing to the SD card. I'm going to speed up the video at this point because this is going to take a while to install for you. Go and get a coffee or something. Another. Now's a good time to take a break. But now through the power of editing, and there you go, we're told that Kali 2023.3 has been written to the SD card, so we can remove it. So I'll click continue, remove the SD card, and then insert it into the Raspberry Pi. So there you go, now inserted. What I'll do now is connect the keyboard and mouse to the Raspberry Pi and connect a monitor. In this case, I'm using OBS on my laptop so that we can see what's going on. And last thing to do is connect power to the Raspberry Pi. So I'll do that. And we should hopefully hear that the fan starts up. And there it does. Not sure if you can hear that, but it's now spinning. And we can see that Raspberry Pi is booting on the laptop. So Raspberry Pi is now running. At the moment, it's not able to connect to a network because I haven't connected it to a network. I could, as an example, connect it to a physical network. I didn't configure the Wi-Fi previously, but just for this example, I'll connect it via Ethernet. And there you go, Kali has booted on a Raspberry Pi 5. Default username is Kali, default password is the same. So Kali, press enter, and I'm able to log in. Okay, so what I'll do is open up a terminal As you can see, the terminal displays Kali at Kali Raspberry Pi 5. And if I use the command IP address, I can see that I've been allocated an IP address on the Ethernet 0 port. The Wi-Fi adapter has been picked up, but it's not currently connected. We'll do that in a second. But as an example, hopefully I'll be able to ping google.com, which I can. I can clear the screen and do a sudo apt update to update my references. References are being updated. Okay, so references have now been updated successfully. What I can do as an example is go to the Wi-Fi networks, and then I could, as an example, connect to a Wi-Fi network. But rather than me, for instance, connecting to the free Wi-Fi, let's see if we can actually attack the free Wi-Fi network and get the password. Now, just a disclaimer before we continue, only attack Wi-Fi networks that you own or have permission to attack. I own this Wi-Fi network, and I'm giving myself permission to attack my own Wi-Fi network using this Alfa network adapter. It's really important that you understand Wi-Fi technologies and the vulnerabilities in Wi-Fi networks, but do it ethically. So a simple way to test Wi-Fi capability is to use wifite. So I'm going to use the command sudo wifite. What you'll notice is it says that no interfaces can be put into monitor mode. So WLAN 0 using this Broadcom chipset doesn't support monitor mode. Wifite tried to put the interface into monitor mode, but that failed. So even though the Raspberry Pi 5 has a built-in Wi-Fi adapter, it doesn't support monitor mode and injection by default at the moment. Maybe that'll be fixed later. This is typically a problem with the Broadcom chipsets on the Raspberry Pis these days. So that didn't work. So what I'll do now is use an Alfa network adapter. This is my new favorite Alfa network adapter. I'll link it below if you're interested. It supports Wi-Fi 6E, so 802.11ax. So very, very nice adapter. So I'll open that. And what it does have is a USB-C to USB-A connector. Now, I just have to do this because of YouTube rules. Alfa sent me this adapter. I didn't get paid to use the adapter. I've bought many, many of their adapters myself, but they have given me this adapter. I need to clarify that for the video, but I'll plug that in and hopefully I'll now be able to see that as an interface. So I'll just use the command iwconfig so we can see Wi-Fi interfaces. What you'll see there is we've got WLAN 0 and WLAN 1, so two Wi-Fi interfaces. And then what I'll do now is use the command sudo wifite to run it again. And as you can see there, we have got another Wi-Fi adapter, as well as the Broadcom Wi-Fi adapter. Now, important note, I didn't have to install any drivers on Kali to see this. I simply plugged it in. So I'll press 2. It's now enabled monitor mode on that Wi-Fi adapter, and I see a whole bunch of Wi-Fi networks. So what I'll do is press Control C here to stop the Wi-Fi attack, and I'll choose 5, our free Wi-Fi network. Let's see if we can attack that. Now, it's trying various attacks against the Wi-Fi network. People often complain about this. Wi-Fi shows WPA, but it's actually WPA2 that's running on that access point. So it tries to do various things to de-auth clients. So what I'll do is use my phone to connect to that network, and I'll put in the password. So a handshake has been captured now. Okay, so the Raspberry Pi captured the handshake between the phone and the Wi-Fi access point using this external Wi-Fi adapter. But it's hanging at the moment. And that's because I didn't do something that I should have done in the beginning. Right at the top here, we told that HCX dump tool wasn't found. The HCX PCAP tool was not found. So we need to run these two commands, apt install HCX dump tool and apt install HCX tools. So make sure that you run those two commands. I've actually run them now. So simply use the command sudo apt install HCX dump tool. As you can see, it's now installed. And then we need to use this command, apt install HCX tools. So sudo apt install HCX tools. That's now been installed. So if I run Wi-Fi again, what you'll notice is it tells us that the interface is in monitor mode. I'll run the attack against the free Wi-Fi network. Now it's trying to run the PMKID attack. So I'm going to stop that and say C to continue. Now, because I previously captured the handshake, so it found the file in the HTTPS directory, it was able to use that captured file and get to the password. This is an example of a really bad password. You don't want to use a password like Spider-Man. You want to use a good password rather than a bad password like that. But notice I was able to capture the handshake and then crack the password because it was an easy password. So if I go into the HTTPS directory and use ls, notice there is the handshake. I could remove that as an example. So sudo rm handshake, let's delete that. So that's gone now. Cd run wifite again. A good option to use is kill. So sudo wifite kill to kill any conflicting processes. Interfaces and monitor mode again. Control C, I'll select the free Wi-Fi network. PMKID attack, I'm going to stop that. Say C to continue. It's looking for a handshake. So on my client, which is connected to that Wi-Fi network, notice it captured or discovered the client. So what I'll do is connect back to that Wi-Fi network. And there you go. It's captured the handshake and was able to crack it again very, very quickly because the password is really bad. This is the word list that it's using. Don't use bad passwords. But there you go. I've now shown you how to install Kali Linux on a Raspberry Pi 5 and use an adapter such as this, which gives you the ability to connect to both 2.4 as well as 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi networks rather than just the traditional 2.4 gigahertz that you often see in videos. Fantastic adapter this. Again, Alfa Network are not paying me to say this, but they did give me this Wi-Fi adapter. This is probably my favorite new Wi-Fi adapter at the moment. Works out of the box with Kali. You don't have to install any extra software, and it supports both 2.4 as well as 5 gigahertz as well as Wi-Fi 6E, which is fantastic. So great adapter. My new favorite Wi-Fi adapter for testing Wi-Fi networks. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like it. Please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and clicking on the bell to get notifications. I'm David Bumble, and I want to wish you all the very best.